Hey, man, you're listening to the John LeBanks Show, man.
The place where chronic brain cell rejuvenation happens.
You feel like you're getting any smarter yet?
Yes.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the second half hour of the John LeBanks Show. Thank you for listening. I really appreciate everybody taking the time out of their busy schedule to give me at least an hour of their life. Now, if you're listening both nights, that's really cool. You're hearing me twice as much because I'm on twice as much, and we're actually gaining radio stations as well. And I'd like to welcome to the family, the Banger Network family, Code Zero Radio out in Utah. We'll be starting on the 16th of May right there at a new station in, well, they're not new, but I mean a new station in our Banger Network. So that's another station added, and we want to give them a big round of applause for bringing us on. And I want to also thank all the other stations that have us on currently. That's AlienXRadio.com, that's WRFN 1025, and that is Vulcan Sound Radio. So welcome Code Zero to the big family here at the Banger Network. Now, I haven't talked about it much, you know, because I've been off a little bit and I've avoided it, but we're getting into the nitty-gritty of the election now. Pretty much it's down to Trump and Hillary. And, well, the fun has started. Trump has slammed Hillary recently. Get this, in Eugene, Oregon, an unrestrained Donald Trump called Hillary Clinton an unbelievably nasty, mean enabler who destroyed the lives of her husband's mistresses during a rally in Oregon on Friday night. The comments made during an evening rally in Eugene, Oregon, marked the sharpest tone he's taken against the Democratic frontrunner since becoming his party's presumptive nominee, and the first time he's been so direct in referencing Bill Clinton's affairs in months. Quote, she's been a total enabler. She would go after these women and destroy their lives. She was unbelievably nasty, mean enabler, and what she did to a lot of those women is disgraceful. Hey, women don't matter to Hillary unless she needs an election. Didn't you know that, Donald? I don't know if you knew that or anybody else out there. They actually think Hillary is for women. Hillary's not for women. Hillary is for Hillary. And if you don't know that by now, then you don't know anything and you should probably stay out. Stay out of voting. Don't even vote anymore. If you don't know that right now in history, Hillary is only about Hillary. She's always been about Hillary. She hasn't been about anybody else. And if you think she actually cares about you women, you're crazy. Please stay out of the election. You have something wrong up here. You probably not, you know, educated properly. You probably went to a public education school. You know, that public education system's just, you know, trust me, stay out of the election. Maybe go ahead and start reading books like Behold the Pale Horse and a few other things. I mean, if you can grasp it. I mean, I know it's hard that since you've been so brainwashed with feminism that you might not be able to understand things like Behold the Pale Horse because that's just a whole new world to you and it just would blow your mind. You wouldn't even understand how that those things could actually happen in a world with Hillary Clinton.
What difference at this point does it make?
His comments came as part of a defense against recent attacks from Democrats focused on the controversial comments and stances on women's issues. Women's issues, because human rights issues are not women's issues according to women, feminists. Women have special issues beyond a regular human that's a man. You know, a white man is a regular human. We're not as special as women. Women need women rights on top of human rights. Trump told the crowd, nobody respects women more than me. Nobody in this country and maybe in the history of this country politically was worse than Bill Clinton with women. That's true. Bill, I don't know. Bill had a lot of women, so maybe he was good with women, you know? I mean, they all wanted to smoke a cigar, just saying. I think Bill might have been really good with women. Maybe not for women, but good with women. He continues, have you ever read what Hillary Clinton did to the women that Bill Clinton had affairs with? And he says, and they're going after him? for women? While it was the most caustic attack against the presumptive Democrat nominee on Friday night, it was by no means the only line of attack he opened against Clinton. He charged that she would be sleeping when national security crisis hit at odd hours. That was a little attack at that ad she did during President Obama's, I think it was like 4 a.m. or whatever. She did a little ad way back when she ran for president, when she lost to Obama. So, Democrats, I want you to think about this, okay? The person who lost to Obama is now running for president. The person who you didn't think was better than Obama is now running for president.
What difference at this point does it
okay?
make?
The Republicans tried that last election by putting Romney up, even though he lost to John McCain, putting Romney up, and you see what happened there. Just saying. These retreads you keep putting out, you know, I know Obama was fresh for you, but I mean, Bernie Sanders and Hillary, those are somewhat retreads in your party, don't you think? That's all you had, right? That's the best you had, Democrat Party, was Bernie Sanders, the old time, old school, old man socialist, or the Hillary Clinton, the fake feminist who only cares about herself.
But I want to say one thing to the American people. I want you to listen to me. I'm going to say this again.
What difference at this point does it make?
I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
We won't even go into the Republican Party because Donald Trump beat them all. All of them. Donald Trump. He's the best the Republicans have. And you wonder why the world thinks we're a joke. And you guys, you people who are going to run out and vote R or D, RD, doesn't matter who it is, RD. You're just going to go out there and vote for these people. Even though this election's been the biggest joke in the history of elections, even though Donald Trump is the best you have, oh, he might be able to save the world, save the country, save everything, right? You think? I don't know, we'll see. Could be just another form of puppet. Remember, he's admitted to paying off politicians. He's paid off Hillary Clinton. He gave money to all kinds of Democrats. You sure he's not a Democrat in, like, sheep's clothing? I don't know. Like I said, I'm probably going to sit this one out. There's nobody to vote for when it comes to anything I believe in. There's not a freedom candidate. Not one. Rand Paul was probably the closest. Trump also took sharp aim at Democrat Senator Elizabeth Warren, the liberal darling who's been the subject of vice presidential chatter in recent weeks, with whom Trump's opened up a feud over social media in recent days. Elizabeth Warren. Could you imagine the president and vice president being Hillary and Elizabeth Warren? You don't think some radical Islamic group who hates women would attack us then? In front of thousands of people on Friday night, Trump unveiled the new nickname for the Massachusetts senator as Goofus. Sure, that's a good name. He says, quote, Clinton's got this goofy friend, Elizabeth Warren. She's on a Twitter rant and she's a Goofus. He continues, this woman is a basket case. By the way, she's done nothing in the United States. She's done nothing. I'm with you on that one, Trump. See, Trump, even though I don't like the guy, even though I'm not going to vote for the guy, guess what? There are things I've got to say, hey, you know what? He's right on. He's right. Even though I don't think he's going to implement any of the things that he's promising, he's not going to get, I mean, he's got to deal with Congress. And Congress is the establishment, it looks like. They all follow President Obama in lockstep. I don't care what anybody says. Anytime the president wants to get something really special gone through, Congress follows along. Woo! So I don't think Trump is going to be able to implement the things he's promising. So all you people who are on the Trump bandwagon, I'm sorry to say, I think you're going to be disappointed. Because the only way he's going to implement this stuff is if he does the stuff we don't like what Obama does, and that's executive orders, and that's doing things around Congress, and we all hate that. So if you want Trump to have his agenda go through, what you're saying is go ahead and do executive orders like the prior two presidents and all the ones before them. Do executive orders around Congress, around law, to get things done. I don't know. I'm not for that. Maybe you're for that. I'm not for that. So I don't think Trump's going to be able, if he's going to follow the Constitution, which if you listen, people, you got to listen to these guys talk. The guy never says anything about the Constitution. The closest he comes to is you're going to have your Second Amendment. We have it now. Well, thanks, Trump. Thanks for promising something we already have. So this is what we're left at here in the United States. And there's no wonder so many people are laughing at us. Because this it's a joke. Donald Trump, Hillary Clinton. Two people that shouldn't be running for president. I don't see either one being qualified to be the president of the United States. Hillary sure isn't. She was the wife of a president. She's accomplished nothing when she was Secretary of State. Either she completely failed at her job or she purposely allowed a lot of things to happen. Donald Trump, sure, he's run a company into the ground sometimes, but he's run a company. Sure, he has some management skills. Sure, he'll speak plainly, which is something I like. But he won't be able to implement things without executive order. And if you're for that, I'm sorry, I can't go with you. Because Congress is not going to work with him. Why would Congress work with him? They've been opposing him. The establishment Republicans and the establishment Democrats don't want to have anything to do with him. So how do you think he's going to get anything done? He's not. Unless he uses executive orders. And I can't go for that. Because there are too many executive orders right now. Too many. We don't need more. We need less. We need a president to write one executive order, discontinuing all the prior executive orders and starting over with a second executive order saying you can't do executive orders anymore. We had a guy that said that. I'll do two executive orders. One to get rid of all the prior executive orders. Two, to cancel all future executive orders. None of them will be null and void. You can't use them anymore. Then I'd be for that guy. Because that's a guy that doesn't want to go around the law, around the way this law is supposed to be made anyways. That's a guy that says, hey, I'm not above the law. I don't make law. I'm the president. I just make sure I administrate the law and make sure our enemies don't mess with us. That's the job of the president. He shouldn't even have to worry about domestic issues when it comes to this, race relations. Let Congress handle that. They're the ones that make law. If there's a racial issue, if there's some kind of racial injustice somewhere, let's see a law out of Congress. Not out of you, President. You don't tell us what to do. You don't try to make laws allowing certain groups into the country and other groups that don't. And it's the voters' fault for putting people like this in office. They don't research who they're electing. Not enough, anyways. You watch a couple TV commercials, might read a couple things of things said by the candidates or things said about the candidates. You don't look into their voting record. You don't look into their history. You think you know Trump because he's been on TV? He's an actor. Trump's private life is not like what you see on TV. Trump's different. He might be a great man in a private life, and he's just a dick on TV. Maybe. I think a lot of people would say that about me. That I seem to be a jerk right here when I'm doing the show, when I'm looking into the camera, because I'm blunt. Because I don't put up with BS and I judge people on behavior. But in my private life, I can tell you that a lot of people think I'm like sweet. I don't know why they think I'm sweet, but they do. Whatever, you know. Oh, well. We got to take a quick break, folks. Last segment coming your way.
You're listening to the Jaume Bang Show.
It's a hell of a good time, isn't it?